Hi, I'm Scotty. Welcome to my channel, Scotties Clock World. Thanks for dropping by.
This is our latest project. A 1917 Gilbert, American Gilbert Mantle clock. Steel plate movement. Why steel plates? Because it was pre-war or very early in the war and there was a shortage of brass for shell casings. Hence the steel plates. I thought initially that the wood looked like cherry fruit wood, but now that it's under some proper lighting, I think it's more likely to be oak. That looks like oak grain down there and down the side. So I've revised my opinion on that. I now think it's oak. It's not pink enough. See, that's not pink enough for cherry fruit wood. All right, we've obviously got a loose hand there, flapping around in the breeze. That's the original weight that came with it. That's the original key. And that small key up there, which is actually the size of a watch key, goes into the top there. I'll open the glass, goes into there and sits on there, and that adjusts the length of the pendulum leader that it hasn't got at the moment. So we'll have to put one of these on, a suspension spring up the top there, the pendulum leader part down there. We'll measure it, we'll see what's written on the back of the plate. There should be a measurement for the pendulum length. We'll cut it to fit, turn it up on the end, and we'll put a bob on it. And then take it from there. I'll close the front glass again so it doesn't get broken. Clicks in there nicely. All right. I'll turn it round. The case is in pretty good shape, actually. There's not very much wrong with it. A little bit of scratching here and there, a lot of rust on it, but we'll remove that. And some of my super duper beeswax formula polish will bring that up rather nicely, I think, without too much worry about it. All right, now here's another thing you don't do when you're working on clocks, and I'll put a small picture of this up and show you exactly what it is. Someone has written their name and date and stuff along the back of the clock. That is a serious no-no. You don't do that. Don't deface clocks and clock cases. There's another one, a big X on there. All right, let's see what we've got in here now. I'll turn that round and lift that up a little bit to give you a better look. Okay. Steel plates, of course. This is the section that lifts the pendulum leader up and down, which isn't there. This one here, the suspension spring, will fit there. It'll go in through the crutch. We'll cut the end of it and bend it, and then put the bob on it. But initially, that seems to be the only part that's missing, but we won't know until we get the movement out. The movement strikes on the hour. Quite nice resonance on that coil gong, though it's a little bit rusty. We'll clean that up before it goes in again. And it strikes a half an hour. Cute little note on a cup bell. All right. So that's pretty much, you can't quite see. The escape wheel is turning when I move the crutch, and there we go, you can see it's working right there. All right, now, first thing we have to do, I'll put the back door on again, close it down, bring that across to hold it. It's a bit tight. There we go, gone too far now. Done. All right, back to the front again, turning it over carefully. Well, the back door held up really well, didn't it? I'll close that again and hold it with my finger this time as I turn it over. That grain's not too bad, and I think that'll come up very nicely with some wax polish on it. A split down the front, but it's 105, 6, 7, 8 years old, so I suppose it's not too bad for that. First thing we'll do, we'll open up the bezel with a glass in it, and no, it's not too bad. All right, that's okay. All right, first thing we're to do is we're to take the hands off, and there's a little knurl nut on there. I'll take that off first, unscrew that, put it in the dish, lift off the minute hand. I think we'll be re-bluing that. Yeah, it's a bit rusty. Now, a couple of fingers underneath the hour hand, or a finger and a thumbnail underneath. Turn it slowly backwards and forwards, lifting it up, and off it comes. Not in quite such a bad condition as the other hand, but we'll blue it anyway. Okay, that's got the hands off it. Close the bezel again. Make sure it's locked down. Turn the movement over. Open the back door. Crack down there also, but for 105 something years, you can't complain. Okay. All right, now, first thing we'll do is we'll take the gong out. To do that, turn the case round, and you can see down here a little nut that's holding it on. I'll use a pair of multi-shifters on it, because you won't have a... There we go. We won't have a little spanner that size up here in the clock room that'll fit. So we'll just run that off. Pull the gong out. I'll put the locking nut back on so you don't lose it. Little bits of rust you can see on it. They're not, ooh, yeah, that side's a bit more serious. It's had a bit more moisture on it. We'll clean that up before it goes back in. All right, and there's our movement. Now, long shaft screwdriver. We'll take the movement out. Undo these four screws in here. And, well, that was not magnetic as it didn't catch. All right, take the rest of these out. Then we can start having a look at the movement. We'll read whatever's written on the front plate. Gather some more information. One's rolled under. Here it goes. I'll put them in a dish in a moment, but we'll get them out initially. Another one, and the fourth one. They're obviously not the original screws that went in. They're far too modern for that. We'll have a look at them all. That's not an early 1900 set of screws, but yeah, they're a little bit rough. Check the other ones and see. That one's not too bad. That one's pretty rough. That's a crappy looking screw. Look at it. The slot out by half a mil, three quarters of a mil, not even in the center. All right, we'll clean those up and recut the slots before we put them back in again. Okay, now time to remove the movement. Lift it out, turn it over. I'll put that down on there for the moment, just to hold it while I remove the case. Connect the back door again, and now lift it up, and there's the movement. Right, let's see what we can see on here. You can see it's stamped 16. That's its year date, 1916. I was only out by a year, so that's not too bad. There's the G for Gilbert. And it says over here, Gilbert Clock Company, Winstead, Connecticut, USA. And The movement seems to be in not too bad a condition. Oh, they're moving around relatively freely. What do we got up here? There's the escape wheel. You can see that turning around when I move the crutch. This wire here's a bit on the loose side. It's also double thickness because it's not the correct thickness. We'll change that when it goes back in. A little bit of oil on it, run over. Though most of the parts seem to be relatively good, but some of the arbors could do with a clean. We'll attack them with some steel wool before they go into the ultrasonic cleaner. You can see here there's oil has run into the in between the leaves there on that pinion. You can see it on the end of the tweezers there. Clean that in a second. And also a fair bit of oil has coagulated down on that arbor there, and the hammer's got pretty good pressure on it. I'll turn that over. We'll see if the count lever's working properly. There it is there. See if it's going to fall into a deep slot. One more. This one. There we go. It's fallen into a deep slot and stopped. So maybe, other than not having a suspension spring and a pendulum leader, this movement mightn't be in too bad a condition. All right, let's start doing some close-ups on this. There's our movement. Now, the first thing we'll do, we'll turn it over, put it face down. We're going to remove the cup belt simply because we can't put the movement flat on my movement holder. Now, I need a 6.5mm spanner for it, and I can't find it. I've got a 6, which is a bit tiny, and a 7, which is marginally larger, so we'll very carefully spin it round. We don't want to put too much pressure on it and strip any threads. A little bit tight, we'll a little bit more with the spanner. That's better. Cup belt comes off. I think we'll be able to clean that up a little bit, I think. I'll just give it a quick run over with a little bit of steel wool and see what a difference it makes, if any. Yep, taking a little bit of rust off. You can see the piece where I've run over with the steel wool there. So we'll run over with the steel wool before we put it back. We may well hit it with a Fordham too to put a bit of a shine on it.